motherhood and hereditary by Matthias Bertrand and Diane Kubrick. This is a paper published in 2011, and it analyzed the effect of a school reform in Charlie on two adolescent risky behaviors, teen motherhood and juvenile crime. I chose this paper because it is about incapacitation effect. Incapacitation effect is a term used in criminology, which refers to a sentence in terms of positively preventing a crime rather than merely detecting it. First, a brief overview. I will describe you the full day school reform in details, which abbreviation is FDS, and its incapacitation effect on the two risky behavior of adolescents. Then I will explain you the data and the empirical strategy the audience used, then some results and the conclusions of their analysis. The starting point of the paper is the increasing concern for economists and policymakers about the risky behaviors that can affect future economic opportunities. Economists and researchers of other disciplines try to understand how public policies can influence adolescent decision opportunities to engage in this behavior, and which of these policy can influence positively the future labor market opportunities of adolescents. Hence, the growing interest in non-academic role of school and its incapacitation effect on this kind of behaviors. The aim of the paper is to analyze the relationship between the reform and the behaviors, and in particular the short-term incapacitation effect of FBS reform on teen motherhood and crime. Let's see in details the education reform in China. In the last 30 years, two major reforms have been implemented. The first one was implemented in 1981, and its central element was the creation of a third category of school beyond public school and private school. So the creation of private owned and managed school, but entirely financed by a fixed prestable subsidy. So private subsidized school or voucher school. The second reform, the one we have to concentrate on, is the full day school reform carried out in 1997. Its aim was to improve education quality by increasing instruction time by 20%, adding 1.4 hours of daily classroom on average only in private subsidized school. Implementing such a reform requires many expenses. For example, operational costs, which are the results of lengthening the school time, for example, the provisions of school lunches. And the main limitation of this reform was the were the infrastructural costs to accommodate students. Because of this cost, the reform was implemented very gradually. Increasing the number of hours spent under adult supervision has had two main effects, one in the long run and one in the short run. The long run effect is increased the human capital, which can influence the future economic opportunities, and the short run effect is the effect analyzed by the authors, the incapacitation effect, so an increase of 20 percentage point of FBS coverage in the municipality increase has reduced teen motherhood by 3.3% and juvenile crime from 11 to 24% depending on the committed crime. The data they used are from CASEN, which is the Chinese National Socioeconomic Qualification Survey, and they use different data to analyze the effect of FBS coverage on teen motherhood and juvenile crime. To analyze teen motherhood, they use individual and family level data, and to construct teen motherhood, they use household composition for information, such as education, health, location, household density, etc. On the other hand, to study juvenile crime, they use municipal level data, to construct the variables, they use Defensoria Penal Pública data, which is the equivalent of Public Defender's Office, and they construct two variables, the total number of crimes, number of property crimes, and number of violent crimes committed by juveniles aged 14 to 17 per 100,000 inhabitants in the municipality. The empirical strategy they used to capture the short-term effect of incapacitation are these two regressions. One to study the effect of the FDS availability on other adolescent motherhood and on adolescent crime. The terms in which these are all control variables, such as municipal characteristic, family characteristic, Ypsilon is the probability that a girl became a teen mother, and crime, the probability that an adolescent engaged in a risky behavior, committed a crime, sorry. But the terms in which we are interested in is BIDA, which measures the effect of the reform on these two behaviors. So let's have a look at the results. The first thing I have to say is that the authors used two measures of FDS. One is the proportion of secondary school which offer FDS coverage during a given year, and the other one is the share of total second enrollment in school which offer FDS reform. Since these results are almost similar, the authors prefer to analyze the first two columns. In the second column, so we have all the control variables used in the regressions. Here we can see that an increase of FDS schools in the municipality reduced the likelihood of teen motherhood. And the percentage is obtained multiplying 20% by the coefficient divided the mean of the dependent variable. Another thing we can see from the table, this table, is that the likelihood of teen motherhood increases with the age. We can see the difference from age 16 to age 19. And another important result is that family composition is very important. It's quite more important than the income of the family. In fact, you can see that, for example, the number of siblings and the number of elderly people in the household decrease the likelihood that a girl became a mother. In the first case, because of the sense of responsibility, and in the case of elderly, because of more adult supervision. On the other hand, we can see that when household density or increase or the household is female-aided, the probability that a girl became a mother is higher. We can compare these results with other studies because this is the first paper which deals about teen motherhood, the incapacitation effect of school on teen motherhood. But we can compare the results of juvenile crime with other studies, and these results, the reduction of on juvenile crime, are consistent with other studies which find that the property crimes are the more affected by an educational reform. These results are important messages and policy implications for Chilean authorities, because the reduction of adolescent motherhood and crime rates can improve their economic future opportunities. So these reforms such these can have many social returns. And another important message is that the impact on teen motherhood improve economic outlooks for unprivileged teenagers. So in the long run, it can reduce the inequities in the labor market. And the most important effect is that after school programs may be a socially profitable investment, and this underlines the importance of school incapacitation effect.